Hello, Doug here, and welcome back to yet another board game channel, and yet another episode of Fortune and Glory, the cliffhanger game, where our heroes are doing meh. We need to collect a total of 30 fortune. We're up to 13. And the villains, the Nazis, are up to 10 out of 15 on the villain track. Once they hit 15, we lose. So, let's see if we can somehow do this. Do this somehow. Alright, first things first. As always, we will be rolling for initiative. Who goes first? It's going to be Sharon going first, but Dudley did roll a 1, which means we get to draw an event card. Ooh, no, just one event card. Oh, it's another lost temple. Just want to make sure. Yep, it's in the discard pile. But yeah, it turns out there's another lost temple out there worth another 6 fortune. So yeah, let's do that. Let's see what it's going to be the Lost Temple of. The Lost Temple of Poseidon, as it turns out. We'll be doing that. What do they say about Poseidon? Ancient Greek lord of the sea, Poseidon ruled over the vast oceans of the world, giving calm winds to those he favored and dashing upon the rocks those he did not. To be favored by Poseidon would mean life or death to those at sea. When you have this artifact, you may always move through sea spaces for one movement each. Okay. So that gives us a 5th artifact slash temple to go after. Let's see where this is going to be. It's going to be in the southwest, referring to the American, North American southwest. So it's going to be right there, and we'll grab 6 fortune to put on that. Oh, yes. We also need to add our little skull token to indicate it's there. All right. Well, in that case, we will be rolling for movement. And yes, we'll be starting with Sharon. Now, Sharon, as it turns out, excuse me, cannot move anyway because she's caught in a cliffhanger. However, we will still roll on the off chance we get another event. Hopefully a good one. Oh, we rolled a 4. So, Sharon's done her movement. She stays there. Now we will be moving on to Shelley Hargrove. Shelley also will not be moving because she got KO'd last turn, which sent her back to her home city KO'd, so all she gets to do is stand up rather than move. However, again, we always get to roll for a move, just in case. Nope, it was a 5. So, that's it for Shelley's movement, and now we will swing over to Dudley. Alright, Dudley in Hong Kong. Actually, don't need anything more than a 2 here to move, because we just want to get him to Shanghai so he can turn this in for a little bit of free fortune. It's his secret delivery. We'll probably never know what the package is. But, let's see, so we want at least a 2. Sorry, got a 4. Alright. So he moves a 1 there, and 1 there, and he's in Shanghai. Now it's time for the adventure phase. All right, Sharon's adventure phase is not going to be a good one. She is stuck in a cliffhanger, fist fight at 50,000 feet. She was on a, trying to get aboard the Zeppelin. Didn't go well. Cliffhanger, fight Nazi. So she does have to fight. Won't be able to use guns during this fight, but she has none. Draw a Nazi enemy's card. If it is not, if it doesn't have the keyword infantry, we redraw, and it's going to have blech, an extra 2 wounds. So we're going to grab the Nazi enemy deck and see. Here's the one. It does not have the keyword infantry, which is good because the flamethrower team looks nasty. So we'll discard that one. Next up, Panzer tank. Okay, we don't do that one again, thankfully. Flamethrower team again. It's not many, just garden variety. Okay, there we are. Plain old Nazi soldiers. It says infantry Nazi. It's going to discard the ones we grabbed. And, yes, they have an extra 2 wounds, which means we actually have to do 5 against them total. Unfortunately, Sharon already has 3 wounds, and this is a fight to the, well, not so much death as the KO. So, Sharon has a combat of 3. She has nothing that's going to help her with that. Unfortunately, there we go. The Nazi soldiers have 4 fight dice. And, yeah, Sharon has 0 defense. Blech. And only 4 wounds left she can take. Right. 4, 5, or 6. Okay, well, they did. They did the 3 to Sharon, and we did 2 to them. So, 2, and add another 3, which means Sharon can only take 1 more hit, and she's KO'd and sent back to New York, which would not be the most disastrous thing. She would lose some of her glory for it, but so be it. Anyway, next fight round. And we get, okay, so Sharon is in fact KO'd. Is she able to KO them? She did another 2. That was a 5, I think. She did another 2. It was 4. Nope, she falls short because they have an extra 2. They actually take 5 wounds. I suppose she could have tried to escape, but that could have gone badly as well. So we'll discard the Nazi soldiers who managed to knock out poor Sharon. Sharon is going to get thrown back to New York City. Delayed. She won't be able to move anywhere next turn. However, her being in a town, in a major city, is not bad. We do, however, have to roll to see how many of her resources she loses. We roll. And we have to get rid of one. Oh, right. I have to look up. There's a chance we can lose the mine. Well, first things first. Let's see what of course she loses 6, so we're going to, she's unfortunately going to lose 6 glory. I could get rid of 5 glory and her driver, but she needs all the help she can get at this point. Oh, and she does also lose the wounds. Just give me a moment to double check what happens to the Mine of Loki she's carrying. Alright, here it is. For each artifact they are currently carrying on a 1-2, roll a die, on a 1, 2, or 3, we lose it. Okay, come on. Ha ha, 6. She does not lose ownership of the Mine of Loki. That is very good, because it's worth a lot, and she can cash that in on her next turn. Alright, that was Sharon's less than stellar turn. It's going to take her and put her up in New York, which is occupied by the Nazis. I don't think this counts as entering, though. I think she just gets to be in New York. I might have to look that up, see if there's any clarifications. Anyway, next up, we will move on to Shelley Hargrove. Now, there's Shelley in Paris, who is going to be up to very little this turn, depending on what the city encounter card is. And, oh look, just another day in the city. You may fully heal, and we reshuffle the city deck. Did I not get that last time? I'm sure I did. But let's do it again. We will reshuffle the entire deck once more. I'm not sure how many of those cards there are. I'm sure there are at least two or three. And that concludes Shelley's exciting turn. Now we'll see what Duke Dudley can do. All right. Dudley is in Shanghai. Before he gets to do anything else, we draw another city card. Look, something different. Shanghai in Shanghai. City, event, treachery. Walking down a dark alley, you are knocked over the head only to wake up in the Far East port of Shanghai. Yes. Your turn immediately ends. Move to the city of Shanghai and lose 3D fortune. If not drawn at a port city, well, Shanghai is a port city. Discard this card. Okay. Well, that's too bad. He doesn't actually get whisked away to Shanghai, but apparently, I think thematically, we can just assume he's been mugged. Which means he's not going to get to do anything else this turn. Boy, this is a bad turn. And we're going to lose some fortune. It is just a D3, not D6. So we're going to divide by 2 and round up. Going to lose... Rolled 3, which means we're going to lose 2 fortune. So... back down to 11. We are so going to lose this. Just having the most appalling luck on some of this. All right. Just checking his cards to make sure there wasn't anything he could have avoided. No, nothing will help him avoid. So that's it. That is it for the really pitiful adventure turn. And now, yay, the villains get to do their thing. All right, see what horrible thing the villains are going to do. Maybe make us lose the rest of our fortune and start over from scratch. Kind of feels like it's going that way. Orders to kill. This card plays on the table. Next time a hero fights a villain... the villain gains +5 fight dice for the first fight round, then discard this card. Oh my god. Well, we're not going to be fighting any villains anytime soon because we can't get anywhere. That means, yeah, we're on to the outpost and Zeppelin phase. Well, let's see if another soldier spawns somewhere. Yes, they do. Of course they do. And a soldier spawning in the Yucatan. Which is going to be right here, Central America, pretty much. And now, let's see... where the Zeppelin tries to get to. It's trying to get to the Forbidden Islands. That's okay. It's about as far away as you can get in either direction. So, pretty sure. Even if we get a 6 rolled. They only rolled a 1. Anyway. It's probably pretty even no matter which way they go. One, two, three. It's actually marginally quicker going to the left side of the map. So they are on. They are actually the Pacific Crossing space. This and this are actually the same space. So they are in sort of on the edge of the map and being in both. All right. Well, now we unfortunately have to do the villain adventure phase. All right, starting with Herr Teufel, who is in the Andes trying to get the armor of lost souls. He only needs two more successes, which I'm pretty sure he's going to get. As he gets to roll four dice, and any sixes count as two successes. Let's see. Actually, that's amazing. He only got one success, and he took two wounds at the same time. So he's only up to three of the four dangers, and he managed to hurt himself a couple of times. Good. Nothing quite as nice as a Nazi getting hurt. All right. Well, that will end Herr Teufel's turn. Now we will be relocating Colonel Stahl. Right, Colonel Stahl is in a readied state, which means we just place him on the board at the artifact with the highest value that doesn't already have a villain. So that is going to be the Lost Temple of Poseidon in the southwest, at a printed value of six. And he shows up with two lackeys. And then we have the end phase, but all of our artifacts are still on the board. Oop, small interruption, I'm back. Right, we are not going to be spawning any new artifacts because everything is still on the board. So, let's do another turn and see if we can get anything to happen this time. Right, first things first, as always, initiative roll. Who goes first? Going to be Dudley. So yeah, let's start rolling for movement. Right, rolling for movement. Dudley, I don't want him to leave because we're gonna try to do this card again. Hopefully the city won't screw us over. Okay, hold three, doesn't move. Next up, Sharon, who I just want to check. Yes, rolling for movement. See if she gets. Okay, she doesn't get anything. No event card. And she, for her movement, stands up. And as a result, because the city is occupied, I'm pretty sure that means she has to draw. Yeah, if you move, anytime a hero moves into an occupied city, I think that's essentially what's happening here. Online is a little. It doesn't seem to be an official ruling on this, but most people are tending towards getting up, and boom, we fight. So she has to choose right away and fight. A Nazi enemy card. Draw a Nazi commander. Betray villain. Let's see. Draw a random Nazi villain and add them to the adventure. must immediately fight a single round against the villain. If not drawn at an adventure, remove the villain after one fight round. If all Nazi villains are already in play, draw a random villain instead. Okay, that means our third Nazi villain will now be activated, unfortunately. It's going very poorly. Means Teresa will now show up as soon as I pick her up off the floor. So yeah, she's going to spawn. Villains always spawn with two soldiers. Which means Sharon might get herself knocked out again right away because Teresa apparently has orders to kill and will get an extra 5 combat dice. Which means her default 3 plus the soldiers, that's 5 plus 5, she's going to get to roll 10 dice. Sharon will roll 3. That's not good. Just double checking. Female Nazi villain. Nomination heroes in her space are -1 defense. Doesn't matter. Sharon's already at 0 defense. And allies in her space are -1 loyalty, which doesn't seem to... Yeah, that's not going to really affect things. Whoops. Not soldier over. Now, because I'm going to be rolling so many dice for the villain, it's all simultaneous, but I'm just going to roll Sharon's first. She hits Teresa for 2. Oh, however, that does give her a couple of glory, doesn't it? That's right, you get 2 glory for each hit. All right. So now we have 8 dice, and we'll have to re-roll another 2. Actually, let's just add 2 white dice. And, okay. That means 1, 2, okay, thankfully that only did 3 wounds to Sharon. Go, and we get rid of this nasty card. That can go away. If defeated, the occupation marker is removed and the city is liberated. Not sure if this counts as having defeated. I mean, we did not die in the combat, even though it was a single fight round. So I'm going to call that... Yeah, I'm going to call that as having liberated, because we got in a fight with Teresa, who went away, thus liberating New York. All right. That means, unfortunately, Teresa's going to start joining the hunt for artifacts. This looks less good every time. All right. Now, Sharon gets to move, finally. She gets her +1 movement. And she rolled a lousy 1. Which means she's going to move a whopping 2 spaces. 1, 2. But we do get an event card. Betrayal Sabotage. Choose an ally in play to make a loyalty +5 test if failed. Okay, that's not really going to apply to a co-op game. Or play while in the same space as the villain to immediately do d6 hits to that villain. Alright, that ends the movement phase. Now we'll be going on to the adventure phase, and we'll see if we can actually get anything done this turn. Alright. Dudley, in Shanghai, after his mugging last turn. And we got this again. Just another day in the city. You may fully heal, reshuffle. So, the third time in, what, 5 card draws we pulled that? Alright, that is reshuffled. Now, the thing I was trying so hard to do last turn, hopefully this will make up for the fortune that we lost from that last very bad card. So we're going to discard it while in Shanghai to gain D6 fortune. We really could very badly use a 6 here. 2. So we broke even. And we're back to a lousy 13. Well, that was terrible, wasn't it? Alright, there's nothing else that Dudley can do there. I guess we will then move on to Sharon. Okay, Sharon in New York. Oh, look at that. I swear to God, I am shuffling thoroughly. Every single time I get this card. But it comes up 90% of the time anyway. Let's do some more shuffling. How many copies of that card are there? Well, at least it means she gets to heal those 3 wounds. For free. Okay. Now, we are going to finally sell the Mine of Loki for, because we're in a major city, 9 fortune. Take away 1 and add 10. We are now up to 22. It's a miracle. Just discard the mine. And while she's here, I think she will do a little bit of shopping. 4, 5, and spend 5 glory. She already has an ally. Yeah, let's see what kind of gear we can get for her. Ooh, she's got the bullwhip. Gear hand weapon will give her +1 combat. Once per fight round, you may force an opponent to re-roll one of their fight dice. If the re-roll is a 1, we have to discard the whip. Not the greatest thing, but better than nothing. Alright, now let's see what happens on Shelley's adventure. Alright, Shelley, who I'm trying so hard to get back to the secret base, rolls to see if anything happens while she's in the Alps. She rolled a 4, which means she gets an event card. On a 4, 5, or 6 on an empty space, you get an event card. So, what do we have? Old differences. Event. Oh, with the lovely flavor text. You bastard! Play to choose any ally in play and discard it. Well, we're not going to do that. Or, play to give any enemy +2 fight dice or any hero or a villain +3 combat for 1 test or fight. Okay. We will keep that in mind if we run into anybody else nasty again. All right. That concludes the adventure phase. Now on to the villain phase. Okay, first step, fill an event. Dark Rituals. Fill an event, power. This card plays on the table. While the villains have at least one artifact that is magic, so we'll look for that symbol, roll a d6 at the start of each villain phase. On the roll of 4 or 5 or 6, move the villain track one step forward, and that remains in play. They do only have one at the moment, and yes, it does have the magic symbol. However, we're already into the villain phase. We are past the start, drawing the card, moved us past the very beginning, so at least we don't have to do that until next turn. Now, we will roll a die for the one secret base, see, get another soldier spawn, roll a 4, so yes. Get a soldier spawn in Italy. Not quite where Shelley is. Now the Zeppelin will attempt to reach to the ancient mountains. They've actually got a chance of getting there. So let's roll and see where it ends up. If they get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Well, they need a 5 because this frozen water space is 3 movement. Let's try that actually in the bowl. 6. Of course. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we drop another soldier there. We have 2 soldiers left. Of course, we got the best roll possible for the bad guys. Alright, now on to the villain adventure phase, where they're gonna get a few more points, almost guaranteed. Alright, Herr Tufel is after the Armor of Lost Souls. He only needs one more success, and he's going to snag it. Because our heroes just can't get anywhere near them to prevent this sort of thing. So, we will be rolling his search of 4. Just needs a single success. And he got 2. So, that means they take possession of the Armor of Lost Souls. And the villain track goes up by another 2. We're up to 12. I think we're only going to last one more turn. Possibly the end of this turn. Depends on how well Colonel Stahl does. So let's go over and check up on him. Alright, Colonel Stahl going after the Lost Temple of Poseidon. He only rolls 3 search dice. However, he is successful on a 3 and up. So his odds are very good. Well, he gets 1 wound because he gets hurt on a 1 or a 2, and that ignores his defense. And he grabs 2 fortune off of there. The bad guys already had 2 fortune there, so they're going to cash in 3. Which raises the track to 13. They need 2 more points. and they win. Alright, we do have to remember to add a couple of danger tokens to the temple, building up towards collapse. And now we actually have a third villain active. So we're going to zoom out and place her. All right, yes, we now have Teresa active in a ready state, so we just have to decide which artifact she's going to go after. it's a three-way tie. All three of the other artifacts. Something in the wrong space here. They're all worth 5 with a danger of 4, which means we get to decide. And I'm not sure if it's going to make all that much of a difference. Well, I think I'll just put her there just because it makes it slightly easier for Sharon to reach a multitude of enemies, so we can choose who she goes after. And yes, that is that. Now we've reached the end phase. We need to respawn the armor. Sorry, a little distracted there for a second. Okay, yes, we are missing one artifact. We didn't lose the temple, which is the one that doesn't get replaced. The others do get replaced. So, it will be at... it will be the Book of the Golden Mummy, worth 4 fortune, 3 dangers, found all over the world. Mummified bodies of the dead are a common sight to behold. The legend of the Golden Mummy tells a tale of riches beyond imagining. See where that ends up. Oh, hey, that's in the Alps. That is exactly where Shelley is. Maybe we'll send her after that. Oops, sorry, I've got the wrong... got the tokens all mixed up. I realize why, because I forgot to put Hartufel back after he got that last. Alright. Now everything's correct. So yeah, maybe I was going to have Shelley go off to try to take out the secret base. Might still do that, because if she can get the secret base, she can actually lower the villain track a little bit. Which we really badly need, because they're 2 ticks away. So that will be that. That will be it for this episode. Next episode will likely be the last one. We're up to 22 fortune. They're up to 13 out of 15 on the track. This is going to be kind of close. Oh, well, thanks everybody for watching. Yeah, thanks for the views and the likes and the subscribes. It's all very much appreciated, and I hope you'll join me next time when we go through yet another turn, probably our last one, of Fortune and Glory, the Cliffhanger game. We'll see you then.